mentioned earlier, my hospitals is organized in association with Hindustan Times, the Bollywood hospitals, the existence of the 40th.
And the audience has been very patiently and eagerly waiting for your arrival. So, Shilpa, you have recently launched a book, The Great Indian Diet, and we all need some start of our first. So, can you tell us a little bit about what motivated you to write a book of this
good body? I'm sounding very immodest right now, but that was my job, you know, look that way. And I just realized it was actually really easy to do if you just had a single mind, you know, single-minded goal-oriented focus and the right nutrition plan. And actually, it was about a lifestyle modification. Believe in what we have or the power of Indian foods. And there are also a lot of misconceptions and preconceived notions with Indian food and curries and whatever. So when I see a photograph of Madonna on Instagram talking very proudly about her putting clarified butter on her gluten-free toast, which is, by the way, ghee, and when I go to London and I go to Holland and Barrett and I see the first shelf stocked with coconut oil and clarified butter, I feel the West values it more than we do. And fortunately, we tend to run after what the West seems to be. So I just wanted to, in a very small way, talk about how easy it was to lose weight, one. More importantly, talk about a lifestyle modification plan, which is so needed in today's life that we lead. We are so stressed out with wanting to, you know, achieve a goal, wanting to reach a certain position, reach from point A to point B, which has become really difficult thanks to the traffic. We've forgotten about being in touch with nature, so forgotten about how important it is to eat the right stuff, forgotten the importance of spices in our country. The power of food can actually be medicine. You know, we wouldn't need, they want to kill me after this, we wouldn't need these doctors. and honestly, I think they would want that even more. It would actually make their life easier. Because we've complicated our lives with complicated foods and bad eating habits, not breathing the right way. How many of you actually take time out and concentrate on breathing? That glow shows on your face. She's the only one that's glowing in this room. So that's what I'm saying. See? Kya baat hai? I'm very proud of you guys. So I just wanted to bring focus back to all the simple things that we have practiced for time immemorial. The West wants to copy us, and we are running after quinoa and olive oil when we have ghee and rajma and dudhi, you know? We don't value those things. So my idea of writing the book was just that, trying to, and unfortunately also for us, we belong to this generation where we ever have a question to ask, or we have a problem, or we want a free solution, we go on the internet and we go into Google. So there's a 2 crore sites that open up if you go into weight loss, how to lose weight. So out of those 2 crore sites, it's actually scary how many sites you shouldn't even go to. Because if you do those things, you'll be dabbed. So I really wanted to do this for those people who firstly can't afford a nutritionist, who firstly don't have, for a layman who doesn't know how to take that first step towards making that lifestyle modification, towards, and you know, the onus also lies a lot on the woman, because we are homemakers. What we decide on in terms of a menu in the kitchen is what your family eats. And you can actually safeguard their lives and make them feel better in the long run with the decisions you make. So I just wanted to make it easy. So So cutting the long story short, that was the idea behind the book. And you know, my husband is British and he always says there's no country in the world that has the word great before, you know, their country, which is true. Great Britain. So I was like, so I have to call it the Great Indian Dive. That's how the birth of this book happened.
So it sounds a lot like your book is about really making life good. And what would be the three top superfoods in Indian,
Well, I swear by ghee, homemade ghee, and I've actually given people the recipe. It's so easy to make. My mother has made it all her life for us. I continue to make it for my son. So ghee, top on the list, great for joints,
yeah.
Okay, great for digestion. You know, it has something called butyric acid, so it actually lines your stomach and it aids metabolism. Coconut oil, I'm Bangalorean, I swear by it. Coconut oil has also been a revelation in the West for Alzheimer's. So I only cook my food in coconut oil. And it would be a toss between flax seeds. Most people are allergic to it. I don't know why there are so many allergies now. So curcumin, which is a derivative of turmeric. Haldi, simple haldi, great usage in our Indian food. And actually most of us are, we're a race that's quite healthy. It's only this generation. I really want to go back to the times as recently as 70 years ago. We used to eat healthier till then. After that, I think aerated drinks and junk food, then all the, yeah, I don't want to take names, I might get sued. But I just think we've complicated our lives with that. But if we just stick to the simple stuff, our lives will become far more simpler.